All right, last but not least, we got bite wings. I usually tend to save these for last. They are most tolerable for the patient, so if they've had a difficult time, you're still usually able to follow to finish up if you do the bite wings last. And so these just go on with the curve of the bite tab following where the cord is. It goes horizontally. In most cases, we're going to do horizontal bite wings and center that right on the center. And honestly, with a Nomad, I like doing it without the rod, but I will show how to set up the rod. And so the rod just needs to come outside the mouth. Stick it this way. And then, like the anterior PAs, the bite wing is pretty easy to set up. Kind of tough to screw up having this go right in the middle. I'm going to start with the molar. So just like with the periapicals, I want it to center toward the distal of that first molar. And on this one, that little notch is going to be roughly the center of your sensor. So you want that notch lined up as much as you can distal to the first molar. The patients can't tolerate too far back there. So usually it's going to be just about at that contact, maybe a little bit on that second molar if you can. This I'm going to try parallel, although it is coming up a little bit. Maybe I'll flatten that angulation just a little bit. So I want to pay attention to where that sensor is. Try to get just the right angulation to open up those contacts. This one was a little far distal. That contact was great. I did capture some of the crown of that impacted third molar. A little overlap there. Sometimes you'll open that up in the premolar. So let's see. If I'm critical, I'd say I also captured a little too much of the maxilla rather than the mandibular bone. We'll try to correct that in the premolar. Let's see, I feel like that's coming out. It's sliding up and down. So try to maintain that in the center. That's probably some of our problem, capturing too much maxillary bone. Bruce has kind of a stiff tongue, which pushes that sensor up when he bites down. So to compensate for that, I'll come down a little bit more. So again, if I'm changing that angulation, I'm going to ignore the ring, and I want to aim at the sensor, because the sensor is what's detecting the x-rays, not the ring. So a little bit of negative angulation. Try to line up my horizontal angulation going right through the contacts of the premolars. This one is good. That looks better. Here we did get that open contact. About as much as I can, I think we opened up the premolar contacts. If I wanted to capture more of this contact, I'd have to bring it more mesially, and then I'd probably create more overlap between the premolars and further distal. Let's go ahead and jump around to the other side. Okay, so just moving to the other side of the bite wings. So just like with the anterior PAs, you don't need to change anything with the ring and the tab. You just flip it over to the other side. So make sure the rod's coming out of the mouth. And see, I've seen students try to do this and then they're shoving the patient's lip back there. That's not going to be comfortable, not going to work very well. So just flip it out to where everything's coming outside of the patient's mouth. We'll go in here, I'm going to line it up for premolars. So as much as I can, I have those premolars in the middle, but you are going to be limited, like we said, with how far anterior you can pull it. And so some of it's just done by angulating the opposite direction. Notice how I have it, I'm holding it against the maxillary tee. I like doing that, and then they can bite right into it without moving it much, hopefully. And that's centered roughly on those premolars. Look at how those contacts are aligned. And I might come back a little bit because I see how these contacts are aligned. And this is going to open up those contacts. See how that one turned out. Looks pretty good. I like the open contacts. I got distal of the canines. Let's take a molar shot. So again, if he's tolerating it, I'll just slide it back. Distal of that first molar if I can. Or right between the first and second molar. I'm coming a little more distally to try to open up the contacts of the molars. All right, I like it. Pretty even levels of bone. This is right in the middle. Pretty open contacts as much as I can with this mannequin. So that's your FMX in less than 10 minutes. I just didn't do the canines on the left side. But that's pretty much it. Thanks.